Good morning students, this is the video lecture for class 10th and the topic is magnetic field due to a parent carrying conductor from chapter 2nd. In previous topic we have already discussed about the magnetic field due to a magnet. Today we are going to discuss about the magnetic field due to current carrying conductor. In this very topic we are going to discuss that whenever we bring a magnetic compass near a current carrying conductor, then it shows deflection. Now we have already discussed that before 18th century it was assumed that magnetism and electricity are two different branches of physics, but after existence of this H.C. Oersted, now this magnetism and electricity are kept under the same branch of physics because they are interrelated to each other. Now you see here, the topic is magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor. Whenever electric current passes through a conductor, it creates magnetic field around it which exists so long as current flowing through it. It means whenever we pass electricity through any conductor, it generate magnetic field around it, and that magnetic field is as so long up to till whenever we supplying the electricity through it. If we stop the supply of electricity, then the magnetic field which is generated around the current carrying conductor is also disappear or stop. It means whenever we passing the electricity through the conductor, it generate magnetic field around it, and this effect was first observed by H.C. Oersted, one of the scientists in 1819. The scientist observed that whenever they pass electricity through it, it generate magnetic field around it. This Hans Christian Oersted from Sweden. Now, what was the experiment? Now, Oersted experiments, Hans Christian Oersted experimented that first of all, he take an open circuit. Now, here you can able to see this is an open circuit. In this very open circuit, there is not any key is inserted in this very plug. This key is open, so there is not electricity flowing through it, no current flowing through it. This is open circuit. When they bring a magnetic compass near this circuit, there is no any deflection occurred in magnetic compass. Now, when they insert a plug key in this very circuit, now it become closed circuit and electricity start flowing through it. Now here you can see that this is the positive terminal of the battery and this is the negative terminal of the battery. When they plug the key, then electricity current start flowing through it, and the direction of current is from this point to this point. Now electricity starts flowing from this point to this point, and when they bring a magnetic compass near it, then there is a deflection occurred in the magnetic compass. And as we know that if there is a deflection occurred in the magnetic compass, then there is only one reason: around the magnetic compass there is some magnetic field. So this magnetic field is generated due to the current carrying conductor. Now when this electricity flowing through this very conductor, there is a deflection occurred inside the conductor. Now in the third experiment, when we change the polarity of the battery, now you can see that when we change the polarity of the battery, now if we give the name to this A and B, A, B, A and B, now here you can see that current is flowing through A to B. So the deflection occurred towards left hand. Same circuit, when we change the polarity, then electricity current flowing from B to A. Now when we bring the magnetic compass near it, then deflection occurred opposite to the left hand. Now this time this deflection occurred towards right hand. Finally, this Oersted concluded that when electricity flowing through the conductor, then it generate magnetic field around it. But if we stop the supply of electricity through the conductor, there is not any deflection occurred in the magnetic compass. Finally, he concluded that whenever electricity flow through the conductor, whenever current flow through the conductor, then it generate magnetic field around it. And the strength of magnetic field, the strength of magnetic field is depend upon the current flowing through the conductor. If the current flowing through the conductor is very high, then the amount of magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is also very high. If the amount of current flowing through this conductor is very low, very less, then the magnetic field produced by this current carrying conductor is also very less. So this is the conclusion finally we get from the Hess-Christian constant, and from that time to till today we got that whenever electricity flowing through the conductor, it generates magnetic field around it. And here's the cause. What is the cause of magnetic field? The cause of magnetic field is current carrying conductor cause magnetic field due to moving charge. Here, the main reason why this current carrying conductor produces magnetic field around it, generate magnetic field around it, there is only one reason behind it. That is the flow of charge. Due to the motion of charge, it generates magnetic field around it. Now, this is the conclusion, this is the cause. Now, how can we define this magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor? This magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor is defined as it is the characteristic of a space due to which a moving charge experiences force at right angle to it and then it turns. Try to understand. Whenever any charge is bring in the magnetic field, then it get trapped. Whenever any charge is bring in magnetic field, then it get trapped. Then why it get trapped? It is trapped due to the force applied by the magnetic field over the charge particle. So, once we try to understand, what is the magnetic field due to a current carrying conductor? It is the characteristic of a space due to which a moving charge experiences force at right angle to it and then it turns. Now, this magnetic field is denoted by letter capital B. Magnetic field is denoted by letter capital B and its SI unit is Tesla. The SI unit of magnetic field is Tesla. Now, what is the force experienced by this? The force experienced by this magnetic field, and now here it is F equal to Q V B. This is the amount of force. First again. Now, experienced by force. How much the force? The force experienced by this F equal to QVB. Here, F is force, Q is amount of charge flowing through the conductor, V is velocity of charge. Here V is not the volt, here V is velocity of charge, and B is magnetic field. Okay, now we want to find out the how much magnetic field produced by the current carrying conductor. So try to understand, if we take here the amount of charge is equal to 1 coulomb and the velocity with which it moving, velocity with which electron is moving or the charge is moving is 1 meter per second. So what is the force? Here force is equal to 1 into 1 into B. So F is equal to B. So how can we define it? We define it if the 1 coulomb of charge going through the conductor, flowing inside the conductor with the velocity of 1 meter per second, then the magnetic field is equal to the force applied by the applied over the charge. So here F is equal to B. Now inside the current carrying conductor, the force is experienced only due to the current flowing through the conductor. The force is experienced only due to the current flowing through the conductor, and the magnetic field can be measured only over the charge. In this phenomenon, F is equal to B. You can also write down here, F is equal to, from this formula, you can write here, B is equal to F upon Q and V. And when the charge is in motion, you can also write down F is equal to F upon I. So B is equal to F upon I. Here F is the force and I is the amount of current. Now, here one's logic you should keep in your mind. The production of magnetic field is due to moving charge. It means whenever there is an electricity flowing through the conductor, it produces magnetic field. And this magnetic field is only produced due to the motion of the charge. And even the detection of magnetic field, how can we say that this current carrying conductor produces magnetic field? Then the detection of magnetic field is done by the force acting on moving charge. It means whenever, suppose if this is the magnetic field, this is the magnetic field, this is the magnetic field, if any charge is built in this, then it will turn at right angle to it. It will turn at right angle to it. This is the amount of charge and this is the B. So it will turn, it is get trapped. Whenever any charge is entering magnetic field, it get trapped by the magnetic field by applying force over the charge. So amount of force applied over the charge, that is the magnetic field. So here with this three formula, we can find out the how much amount of magnetic field is produced by the current carrying conductor, and this is your formula. Now, here we are going to see how can we detect the direction of magnetic field of a current carrying conductor. Because in previous lecture, we have seen that the magnetic field line of a bar magnet. So what is the direction of magnetic field of a current carrying conductor? So here in this three direction diagram, you can able to see if this is a straight long wire. If this is a straight long wire and the high amount of current is flowing through it, so the direction of magnetic field is produced around this current carrying conductor is circular. But if it is circular, then what is the direction of magnetic field? Because in bar magnet you have seen that the direction of magnetic field is from north pole to south pole. It is just like from this and like this. So what is the direction of magnetic field in this way? So for this we have a very best method, and that method is what? That method is right hand. By this rule we can able to find out the direction of magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. What is this rule? This rule states that if we hold if we held the current carrying conductor in such a way that thumb stretched Now, this right hand thermistor states that if we heat the current carrying conductor, suppose that this is the conductor and the current is flowing from this point to that point, from bottom to top, and then we have to hold the current carrying conductor in such a way that this thumb stretched in the direction of current. This thumb stretched in the direction of current, then the rest of the wrapped finger, rest of the wrapped finger shows the magnetic field around it. So here we hold the, suppose that if we hold the conductor, if we hold the conductor just like in such a way, then rest of the curved finger shows the magnetic field around it. So here magnetic field is just like in this direction it is moving in anti-clock. So whenever any current is flow from bottom to top in a straight wire, then direction of magnetic field is anti-clock. There are various methods by which we can able to find out the direction of magnetic field, and those methods are, the first one is the right hand thumb rule. Second is the slow rule. Third is the Ampere's swimming rule. Fourth is the corkscrew rule. These are the rules by which we can able to find the direction of magnetic field of a current carrying conductor. This rule states that whenever electricity flows through the, suppose that this is the direction, this is the north pole, this is south pole, this one is east and this is west. Then this slow rule states that whenever electricity flowing through south to north, whenever electricity flows from south to north, then when we keep the magnetic needle compass near this current carrying conductor, then deflection occurred over west. S for south, N for north, O for over, W for west. Then this slow rule states that whenever electricity flows from south to north, then if we keep a magnetic compass near current carrying conductor, then deflection occurred over west. So this is the slow rule for finding the direction of magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. This Ampere swimming rule states that if a person is swimming in a pool and the electricity is flowing from leg to head, and if the person is swimming inside the pool, then if we bring a magnetic compass near the person, then the deflection occurs towards left hand. Then it means, it's very simple, if we stand like this and I am swimming inside the pool and this electricity moving from leg to head, it means bottom to top, then deflection occurs towards left hand. If we keep the magnetic compass here, then it will deflect towards left hand. This is the Ampere swimming rule. Now corkscrew rule is what? Corkscrew rule is also same. You have seen the screw. Aap logon ne screw dekha hoga. If you are rotating the corkscrew clockwise, then it is going downward. If you are rotating the screw anti-clockwise, then it is going upward. It means, it says that if you rotating the screw clockwise, it means the direction of magnetic field, if it is clockwise, then the direction of current is top to bottom, and if you are rotating the corkscrew is anti-clock, then the direction of current is bottom to top. So these are the methods by which we can able to find the direction of magnetic field around a straight current carrying electricity due to a circular loop. In previous, now magnetic field due to a circular loop. We have right now we have seen that magnetic field due to a straight current carrying conductor. If it is a straight current carrying conductor, and if I bend it in the form of circular loop, if I bend it in the form of circular loop, now what is the final direction of magnetic field? Then you have seen that this is the direction of magnetic field throughout the straight current carrying conductor. It is anti-clockwise direction. So if I bend it, so throughout the circular loop, the direction of magnetic field is moving inside the board. Just you have seen that all the direction of magnetic field is just assumed that they are going inside and from outside they are coming outward. And inside they are going inside. Reason what? The concentric circle represents the magnetic field around it. Now, this all magnetic field lines become concentric and they align, they aggregate, and finally they make a single magnetic field line, and this is the straight wire, straight direction. Now here you can see that the direction of magnetic field is from this direction, this direction, this direction, finally it comes to this direction. So at the center of the loop, the field lines are straight. There is one another method is also by which you can find out the direction of magnetic field, and that is the same thing is right hand thumb rule. But right now the system gets changed. If the wire is straight at that time, if you hold the current carrying conductor, then this thumb shows the direction of current. This thumb shows the direction of current, and this rest of the finger shows the direction of magnetic field. But in circular loop, it gets changed. In circular loop, this curved finger shows the direction, and this thumb shows the direction of magnetic field. In circular loop, this curved finger shows the direction of current, and this thumb shows the direction of magnetic field. So here you see, this is the direction of current, and in this circular loop, this is the direction of current. So this is the direction of current, and thumb going inside. So the direction of magnetic field is going inside. Suppose that if the current is going in just a way, if the current direction gets changed, if I reverse the polarity, then current direction gets changed, and if the direction is this, then the direction of magnetic field is this. It means in circular loop, this right hand thumb rule, this curved finger shows the direction of current, and this stretched thumb shows the direction of magnetic field. So this is one of the best method to find out the direction of magnetic field around a current carrying conductor, whether it is a straight current carrying conductor or circular loop. Now we are going to discuss about the what is the strength of this magnetic field inside a current carrying conductor. Then the strength of magnetic field inside a current carrying conductor is depend upon two things. Strength of B inside a current carrying field means magnetic field inside a current carrying conductor is depend upon two things. The first thing is it depends upon intensity of current. It means how much amount of current flowing through this conductor. If the amount of current flowing through this conductor is very high, then the magnetic field is also very high. And second is it is inversely proportional to radius of loop. It is inversely proportional to radius of loop. It means B inversely proportional to radius of loop. If the radius of loop increases, then the magnetic field produced inside this current carrying circular loop is decreases, because it is inversely proportional. If radius is decreases, then magnetic field increases. Now we are going to discuss about the effect of a solenoid. First of all, we should know about the what is solenoid. So here, solenoid, it is a long coil containing a large number of closed circular turns of insulated copper wire in the form of cylinder. It means if this is a long wire and if we run in the form of this and if we pass electricity through this one and this one, then it will become a solenoid. So if we pass electricity through this solenoid, then what is the direction of magnetic field? Because in the right now we have seen that in a circular loop, if we pass electricity, then what is the direction of magnetic field? So if we increase the number of turns of this circular loop, then it becomes in this shape. So if it is in the form of solenoid, and if this solenoid carry current, if we connect this solenoid with the help of battery, so electricity start flowing from this direction to this direction. If in this return electricity flow from this terminal to this terminal, so this current carrying solenoid which also produces magnetic field around it, and the direction of magnetic field is just assume that the direction of magnetic field of a bar magnet. So here if we supply the electric current through the solenoid, then you can able to see this direction of magnetic field line. Here the direction of magnetic field line, it just assume that it is originating from north pole and terminating at south pole. So this is the direction of magnetic field line of a current carrying solenoid. Next, we are going to study about the electromagnet. In electromagnet, we are going to study about how this current carrying solenoid is behave like a electromagnet.